Let me show you how you can create 5 smooth text animations inside of Adobe After Effects. This is gonna be very easy and simple, and I will also show you how you can create a different background for these animations. So this is Vikash from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's go. Alright, so this is Adobe After Effects, and let's start by creating a new composition. Click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition. This is going to be our main composition. You can also call it render comp. Set the resolution 1920 by 1080, frame rate 60 for a smooth animation. Duration make it 3 seconds long for one text animation. Background color black, hit OK. First of all, we have to type a text over here. So select the text tool, go to character. If you don't have this character, then go to window and check this option character. Select your favorite font style. So in this case, I'm using Gotham. So this is the Gotham font style. I'm gonna select the style bold. Set the size something around 220 pixel. And this is the character spacing, which is kerning. You can set the value negative 50. And then click over here and type anything, whatever you like. Once done, hit Ctrl A to highlight all, and this is the color. You can select a light color, maybe pure white, hit OK. Perfect. Now we have to align the text in the center. So this is the paragraph. First of all, you can set that paragraph center text. Go to align, click on align horizontally, align vertically, and keep the text in the center. I'm going to create a very basic text animation first. So select the move tool, just go to layer, new, and take a new null object. I'm going to use this null object as a size animation. So right click on the null object, click on rename, or you can also select the layer, hit enter, and then I'm going to call it scale or size, hit enter. Now I'm going to parent this text layer with the scale. So it's very easy. This is the parenting option. Here we have to pick this pick whip and attach this pick whip with this scale null object. Perfect. Now you can open the scale transform, and here we have the scale property. And if you want to bring out the scale only, hit S on the keyboard to bring out the scale property. Now just go to 1 second and 15 frame, I guess. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the scale property. Go to 45 frame back in time on the frame number 30, I guess. You can add one more keyframe by clicking on this diamond button. Just go to on the first keyframe that we have created, and you can increase the size value. So I'm going to set the value 120%. Now hold the position for 30 frame, maybe half a second. So just go to half second forward in time and click on the diamond button to add one more keyframe right over here. Just go to 45 frame forward in time, which is 2 seconds and 30 frame. And here we have to set the scale value 100. Perfect. So this animation is linear animation, as you can see. Highlight all the keyframes, hit F9 on the keyboard to make them easy ease. You can select any one keyframe. Go to graph editor. If you don't have this graph editor like this, right click on that, click on edit a speed graph. Perfect. Now highlight these keyframe, hold this handle and drag it on the left hand side. Similarly, highlight this one, hold this handle and drag it on the right hand side. Perfect. You can also adjust these handle. Simply you can set the handle right over here like this and do the same thing at the end. Now we have smooth animation. Perfect. Each time we will use same basic setting that we have created right now. So what we have to do, this is the render composition. Let me rename this render composition. Just right click on that, click on rename. This is going to be the text one, so I'm going to call it text 01. I'm going to select this text 01 composition inside of this project window. Hit Ctrl D on the keyboard 4 times, and now we have total 5 different copy for 5 different text animation. And now let me create the first text animation. So here we have the text layer of this text 01 composition. Open it up. So in the first animation, I'm going to add opacity from here, and I'm going to add one more property inside of this animator one. So I'm going to click on this add button, not on the animate. And I'm going to add the position property. And here we have the opacity and the position. So this is the X position and this is the Y. So I'm going to animate the text in Y direction. So let's set the Y position value something around 400. Perfect. And this is the opacity. I'm going to set the opacity value 0. Now open the range selector, go to 1 second. This is the offset. I'm going to set the offset value 100. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the offset property. And then just go to very first frame of this animation. This is the offset. Let's set the offset value -100. Perfect. So here we have something like this. And of course it is not looking good. So what we have to do, just open the advanced and here we have the shape. So change the shape square to ramp up. Perfect. And here we have the ease high and ease low. I'm going to set the ease high value something around 80%. And this is the ease low. I'm going to set the value 60%. Perfect. Here we have something like this, which is looking absolutely interesting. I'm going to close this text layer. This is the motion blur option. Just turn on the motion blur for both the layers. And here we have the first smooth text animation, which is looking very interesting. Now let's jump over the second title animation. So this is the second title composition that we have created. Just double click on this text 02. And here we have the basic setting, as you can see, that we have created initially. And now let me create the text animation. So open the text layer, open the text, and as usual, I'm going to add the opacity parameter from the animate. I'm going to add one more property. So click on the add button, go to property. Let's add position. I'm going to add one more extra parameter, which is tracking amount. So click on the add button, go to property, and this is the tracking. Perfect. Here we have all the settings. So for the second one, I'm going to set the position something around 400. This is the opacity and this is the tracking amount. Let's set the tracking amount -60, I guess. And this is the opacity. Let's set the opacity 0. I'm going to animate the range selector. So open the range selector. This time I'm going to animate the start, not the offset. So what we have to do, just go to 1 second. This is the start. Let's set the start value 100. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the start property. And then just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the start value 0. Now we will get something like this. Here we have very basic animation. So what we have to do, select both the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor. Here you can place the CTI on the frame number 30. Make sure you have to create this type of peak. So here we have something like this, which is looking absolutely perfect. Now you can close the graph editor, close the layer. And now let's jump over the third one. So open the text 03. And here we have the basic setting that we have created initially. So open the text layer, just click on the animate, add the opacity parameter, click on the add button, go to property. And this time I'm going to enable the pre-character 3D. Click on add one more time, go to property, and I'm going to add this rotation property. I'm going to use the X rotation only. So I'm going to remove the Y rotation and the Z rotation. So simply select the Z rotation, hit delete button, Y rotation, hit delete button. Perfect. Now let's animate the X rotation and the opacity. So let's set the X rotation value -90°. And this is the opacity. Let's set the opacity 0. Now open the range selector, go to 1 second. Here we have the offset. Let's set the offset 100. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe. Go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the offset value -100. After that, just open the advance. Here we have the shape. Let's change the shape square to ramp up. Set the ease high something around 75. And this is the ease low. I'm going to set the value 50%. Now you can see here we have something like this, which is very smooth and very unique text animation. Perfect. Now you can close the text layer and here we have our third text animation. Now let's jump over the fourth one. So simply I'm going to open text 04 composition, and here we have the basic setting. Now let's create interesting animation. So open the text layer. This is the animate. Click on the animate button, add an opacity first, and then click on add. Let's add the scale property. Click on add button again, go to property, and this time I'm gonna add the tracking. Let's add one more. I'm gonna add the position property as well. Now let's do some setting. So this is the position. I'm gonna set the X position something around 100, leave the Y 0, and this is the scale. Let's set the scale value 0%, opacity 0%, tracking amount 100. Now let's animate the range selector. So open the range selector. This is the offset. Just go to 1 second, increase the offset value to 100, turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the offset property. Just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the offset -100. Go to advanced, just change the shape, ramp up, increase the ease high value and set the value 80, ease low 50. You can see here we have very interesting text animation which is looking absolutely perfect. Now let's jump over the fifth one. So I'm gonna close this layer. Just open the fifth one. This is the fifth composition. This is the basic setting. As you can see here, just open the text. This time we have to add Y rotation, but before that you can enable pre-character 3D first. Click on the animate, add the rotation. This time I want the Y rotation, so I'm gonna delete the X rotation and the Z rotation. Perfect. So here we have the Y rotation only. Click on add button, go to property, add the opacity parameter, and then I'm gonna add the tracking amount as well. Perfect. So here we have the X rotation. I'm gonna set the value something around -180°. Perfect. This is the opacity. Let's set the opacity 0. Here we have the tracking amount. I'm gonna set the value -60. And then I'm gonna open the range selector, go to 1 second, increase the offset to 100, turn on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe, go to very first frame of this animation. Let's set the offset -100. And then we will get something like this. Open the advance, and here we have to repeat the same thing. Just change the shape square to ramp up, and this is the ease high and ease low. So I'm gonna set the ease high value something around 80 and ease low 50 as usual. Perfect. And now you can see here we have very interesting text animation. Perfect. So this is the fifth text animation. Now you can turn on the motion blur for all the text animation. Perfect. So here we have 5 different text animation. And now let me show you how you can create different background for these animations. So in the first one, we have to use a black background or maybe a gray background. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer. You can select a gray color maybe, or you can select a fully black background. Perfect. Hit OK. You can place the black background below this text layer. And now here we have the black background and the white text, which is our first background. And then you can create the second one, which is just inverse of the first background. So in this one, just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid. This time I'm going to use the white background. So this is the white background. Place the white background just below this text layer. Select the text, go to character and select the text color pure black. So here we have the white background with black text animation. And now let's create the third background. It is again very simple. I'm going to create a new solid layer. Now place the background below this text layer and then just go to effect and preset and search for four corner. So this is the four corner gradient. I'm going to apply the four corner gradient on the white background, and here you can select a nice and simple gradient color. So here we have the colorful background for the text, which is also a good background. Perfect. And now let's create the fourth one. You can use any image as a background. So it's very simple. just go to folder and drag and drop any image. I'm going to use this one. Simply drag and drop, place the image below this text layer. I'm going to down the size of the image just a little bit. So basically we have to fit the image. And now just go to the end of this animation. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the scale property. Just go to very first frame. Let's increase the size just a little bit. So I'm going to set the value 65%. Now you can adjust the opacity. Hit T on the keyboard to bring out the opacity. Let's set the opacity maybe 20% or maybe 15. Now it's looking nice. And here we have nice and simple image background. You can also make the background black and white. Simply you can apply tint effect from here. Perfect. This is the very basic thing. Now let me show you the last one. So I'm going to use any video instead of the image. Just go to folder and I'm going to use this background. Simply drag and drop to the After Effects. And this is the background. You can place the video clip inside of the text layer. In this case, I have a black and white video, which is looking like this. You can use any video clip that you like and then select the background, hit T on the keyboard to bring out the opacity. Let's set the opacity 15 or 20%. Now you can close the layer and here we have something like this. So these are the background that you can use for this type of text animation. Let's have a look. So that's a wrap for today's video. I hope you like it. For more such videos, subscribe to this channel, like this video, and also comment below what you think about it. My name is Vikas Kumar and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye-bye.